Hi guys, welcome back to Harry Makes Up. Today I'm going to do the super lovely Foxes. I'm going to do the makeup look I did on her for the Body Talk video, which I'm going to link below. It's going to be a really fun look. We're going to have a really serious time where we're going to show you how to get the makeup look. And I really hope you guys enjoy the video. Louis base, which I've already prepped, we've just used a bit of Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk, and we use this quite a lot, don't we, Louis? This is a really nice one.
Yeah.
And then I've used a little bit of the Charlotte Tilbury the Retoucher in number 3, just under the eyes and a little bit around the nose as well. So the next thing we do when we're doing Lou's makeup is I'm just going to prep with an eye base, and this is the Clarins one. It's a 4 minute base fixant les yeux. Harry doing French.
That's very good French.
And close me down. So I just put this over the eyelid and it just makes the look really nice and clean. So we filmed Body Talk in Barcelona, didn't we, Lou?
We did, and
it was a
nice shoot.
Do you want to tell everyone about that shoot, because it was very long.
It was, so what did we do? We did 8, no, that was earlier, wasn't it? It was like 6 p.m. until 10 a.m. or something.
Yes, it was quite impressive. But the lashes I used on the day on Lou, I used a pair of the Natural Ardells in 110, which were really nice on top. And then we're both loving the Eldora ones, aren't we? These really nice little bottom lashes.
Yeah, I love them.
They're so good. They come in little like packs
They're
of
really
two,
good.
So you can make perfect kind of Jane Birkin lashes on the bottom and just mix them up.
Well, for ages we were doing
it. Would, yeah.
So we'd be at shoots, and for ages we'd be like using the mascara, and it would take up like 15 minutes.
It would take so long. These are like our cheat.
Then we discovered these, and we were just like, ooh. But remember when we tried to put them on in the back of a car?
Yes, I was going to tell that story. We did have to, on a motorway, we managed to apply eyelashes to you, didn't we?
We did.
Whilst you were laid on my lap, and there was tweezers involved, so it was extreme sports makeup almost. It was quite intense.
But you didn't get me in the eyes.
No, I feel good. Actually we survived that. We lived to tell the tale, and Louis still has her eyes intact. Where's your beauty kind of inspirations come from, Lou?
I take a lot of inspiration from 60s makeup.
Mm.
I really like how exaggerated it is actually. And I think there was definitely just like a set look, wasn't there?
Yeah.
And it was kind of
statement lashes.
Yeah, it was just like you could just put loads of mascara on. And then a lot of inspiration came from Edie Sedgwick, because I just love the way she used to actually like make her own eyelashes.
And layer them. She used to layer like 3 or 4 pairs sometimes. Yeah. So they were like so intense just to... Yeah. Must be quite heavy, I would say.
She did it all herself. So.
It looked time for me. So I'm just going to take a Max Factor False Lash Effect and put a little coat on before we put the falsies on. This is the mascara you like to use if you are doing your, we'll call them sunray lashes.
Yeah.
This is the one we use. It's a really affordable mascara and it's really good. This is the waterproof one as well. So if Lou's on tour or if she's doing something, I don't have to worry about it kind of running under the eye. So I'm not going to put any mascara on the bottom lashes, because what I think you find with the Eldora ones, which are these little kind of things of 2-in-1, it's better off, you kind of get more of the effect by leaving nothing on the bottom lashes, so just use these where you need them. I'm just going to use a bit of Duo Eyelash Glue, because I find this lasts really, really well, and I know they'll stay in place.
I can never put false lashes on, you know.
I
really find it hard.
I think it's one of those ones, you almost want to watch like EastEnders or something, and just sit with a little mirror and just keep practicing. Like one of those things, the more you practice, the easier it is. Yeah, and just have like, I think use a tool to help you. So I always find using a pair of tweezers makes it easier. So I've just got one little piece of the lashes in the tweezer, and I'm just going to pop it in the Duo Lash Glue. So if you look straight ahead for me, Louis. So what I do is, if you look up, I want it to go almost sat underneath her natural lash. So if you look up, so I like to start on the outside and work inwards, and then just as the glue gets more tacky, like I said, it's more kind of malleable that you can move it. And then I just use the little tweezers just to kind of move them into flow. And just keep looking up for me, Lou. So I'm just using the same space pretty much for this one. And again, you just need to make sure the glue's really well tacky so that it does move. And then you've got a bit of time just to work with the lash. So if you look towards the camera, you can start to see the shape coming together now. So I've just put the last one on, that's the inside one, and it's the shortest one that comes in the pack. So hopefully you can just see with Louis looking straight ahead, all googly-eyed, they just give a really nice kind of 60s, nice sort of Jane Birkin-y reference eye. And these are what we had in the Body Talk video as well. So I've just put some Jury Lash Glue on the top lashes, and we have to do the lash dance. Yeah, so just make sure it's really, really dry before you put them on. So I just generally put them in the middle of the eye first, just so they kind of attach properly. And then I'm just going to pull the inner corner tucked in, and you just want to push it towards the skin, but so they're just resting on top of the lash. So, and I find sometimes the inner corner, if it's too sharp, that's the bit that will be a bit uncomfortable. So just make sure it's tucked in really, really well. How's that feel?
Fabulous.
The great thing with working with Louis as well is you'll bring like references to me, won't you? And you bring ideas, yeah. And you know, she'll have someone that we might kind of mix up different style icons and then different kind of techniques that we've sort of made together as well.
I love finding, you know, icons from the past. I think that's
me too.
Really important.
Do you have a favourite, Lou?
I think Edie Sedgwick and Bridget Bardot are big favourites.
Yeah.
Probably Bridget Bardot for her hair,
yeah.
And then makeup, Edie Sedgwick.
Edie Sedgwick,
I just love
who else have we referenced? We've referenced Stevie Nicks before.
Stevie Nicks, said. Yeah.
Jane Birkin, sometimes
Jane Birkin, hair lashes. I love, yeah.
So the next thing I like to use on Lou is the YSL bronzer. I think this is in the shade, it just says Taya Saharian. I'm really bad at pronunciation.
Let's see.
We'll let Lou have a go at pronouncing it.
Taya Saharian.
Yeah, that sounds good. So we're going to go with that. I'm going to use the Charlotte Tilbury sculpting brush. And I really like this, not so much to contour on Lou, because Lou doesn't need contouring, and I don't think it's a particularly 60s, part of that kind of 60s look, so we don't
really wear
any blush or, you know, anything, sometimes just no even foundation.
Yeah.
So I'm just using this, and I just use this to add a bit of colour to the cheeks, and a little bit of shape, but without it being kind of sculpted.
I really need to get this, because I don't actually have it. I'm going to buy it, I like it.
And it's matte, so there's no shimmering as well.
Yeah. Is the good one. I think when it's matte, it kind of makes it look a bit more natural, actually.
Yeah, you get that more kind of sun-kissed feeling.
When I was younger, I used to buy, do you remember, like, God, oh, what was it?
Do you remember bronzing pearls?
Yes!
Yes!
I used to buy bronzing pearls from, like, the body shop. From the body shop, and you just put it in, and it was literally just, like, putting glitter straight on your face.
Dabbing glitter, and then putting it all over your face. I remember when Natural Collection did bronzing pearls. That was, like, my first makeup purchase, I think, as a 12-year-old.
And I used to just, when I was younger, I just used to have strips of bronzer.
I was going
to
say,
I was going to
say, what's your, like, teenage, when you look back, do you have any, like, makeup times you look back and think, oh, that was tragic?
I was horrific.
I was really bad.
So I used to get, like, white glitter, Barry M white glitter. Yeah. This is no joke. I once walked into my maths class and the teacher, like, stopped the whole class and said, how long did it take you? She went, if you put the amount of time into putting your makeup in the morning to doing, like, to revising maths, you'd be a mathematician right now, young lady.
Wow. So the next thing I like to use on Louis to give that really nice dewy finish, which I know is what you love, isn't it, Lou? So I'm going to take Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector. My pot broke, because I've had to put it in another pot, and this is in Opal, but it has a really nice kind of gold glow to it that's a little bit peachy, a little bit opaly. It's just really pretty. So just with my finger, I'm just going to take a bit off on the back of my hand first. So if
I really like the way you just described it. Then.
Was that a good, just an accurate description?
Opaly.
It's called Opal, so. So I take a little bit down the bridge of the nose. Just to give that glow. And then if you turn the other way for me, Louis, then I take it on the top of the cheekbone. And this is really nice. It's just a really, really subtle highlighter. It's not glittery. It's not, the particles are really, really fine in it. So it just looks super natural and part of the skin. So one of the questions I get asked most is, what I use on your lips, Louis? That's something I always get asked. So I feel like I'm finally able to tell you guys, as I'm here with Louis herself.
Yeah.
So we generally use lip liners to do kind of the whole lip look. Sometimes we add a little bit of lipstick, but the two we always come back to is MAC Boldly Bare and MAC Well. So they are kind of the staple ones we use a lot, aren't they?
Yeah. Well, they're the ones I've been using them for, like, 3 years.
Yeah, like, since you started, really, haven't you?
Yeah. But I used to just use them as, like, colour. Mm. Because I liked the matte finish yeah. that they gave.
And they're really long lasting as well when you use a lip liner. That's yeah, the exactly. other good thing. You get like a really long lasting finish.
Yeah.
If you can't find MAC lip pencils, because I know a lot of these have been selling out at the minute, another one that we do use sometimes, which Louis actually introduced me to, is the Gosh lip liner in, I think it's called Nougat Crisp in 001. Which you can get from Superdrug, and this
is very good.
Is a really, really good, similar colour, actually, to the ones we're going to use.
Yeah.
So, generally, I tend to use Well first around the outside, and then I blend in a bit of Boldly Bare as well. So,
yeah.
I'm going to get Louis to do her best smile for me on camera.
Mm-hmm.
And we just really give that nice kind of full look to the lips. Again, very Bardot-inspired, and just kind of referencing those nice kind of 60s icons that we both really love.
Mm.
So... and it's just going to give a really long-lasting finish.
And this is where Harry hears my hum.
I hear, yeah. Louise sings me a song while I do her makeup. So I'm just going where the top lip is, just ever so slightly over the edge, because Louis naturally has amazing lips. So it's just...
thank you, Harry.
Oh, you're welcome, Louis. And then you just want to make sure they're joined as well, so... you just open your lips slightly, Louis. So I just make sure the corners, there's no kind of edges showing, or you just want it so it's joined all the way around for a really natural looking finish. And then I'm just going to take a lip brush and I just kind of buff that through as well first, just to make sure, again, it's kind of about making it last as well. So I just buff that over just to make sure it's always really blended.
Have you ever had anyone do that?
What, bite the lip liner?
Eat your makeup.
No, not yet. So then in with Boldly Bare, and if you smile again for me, Lily, then I just take Boldly Bare into the centre. So it's almost like a natural highlight as well in the lip, which again makes them just look a little bit fuller as well, which is nice. And then just with your finger, you can kind of blot it in a little bit. So for brows, I just do a little bit of MAC Mystery, this dark colour here. So I just give Louis's brows a little groom, and then just using a MAC 266 brush, just give a little bit of filling into the brow. And so I'm just giving a little bit more thickness, but a very slight amount. And just with what's left on the brush, I go into the inner part, but most of the product's on the outer part of the brow. So that is the finished look, guys, on lovely Louis. Thank you for letting me borrow your face.
Thank you for having my face.
It's been really, really fun, guys. Make sure you contact me at Harry Make Yourself on Twitter if you have any makeup-related questions. And I'm going to leave all the links to Body Talk down in the description box below. And I'll see you soon for more videos. Thanks very much, guys.
Bye.